All right, so this is Pax Viking. The point of this game is to become the first Swedish monarch through either military, religious, or trade dominance. The first thing I'm going to do is explain the map. So the map is separated into winds. So you have the blue north wind, the purple west wind, the orange yellow south wind, and the green east wind. All right, those winds are then further separated into regions. So regions are anything with a name. So there are sea regions and land regions. Gamvik is a sea region, Sea of Remembrance is a sea region, Bjarmaland is a land region, Vens is a land region, right? So any named area is a region. Then those regions are further separated into posts. So any circle is a post, right? So there are three types of posts. There are venture posts, which are the ones that have that you can put something on them, right? So in this case, that's a venture post. There are trade centers, which are these gray circles, and there are powerful allies, which are these brown circles. Right. So
Okay.
that is the map. I'm gonna explain the tile anatomy real quick. So there are four types of tiles. There are advocates, there are vents, there are ventures, and there are gods. Let me see if I can find a god in here. Yeah. So this is a god. All right. So I'm gonna go over the tile anatomy real quick. So this venture right here, this one right here, you'll notice that it has at the top a V to show that it is a venture. Events have a crown, advocates have a little person, and gods have a shiny eye. All right, so that'll tell you what type of tile it is. Then you have the requirement right below that. The requirement is where your longship needs to be in order to play that tile. All right. Then on the top left, you have the type of follower that goes on that tile. So for this one, that's a ruse follower. All right. Then on the right, you have a trigger icon, and that trigger icon tells you how that tile is triggered. Right. So for this venture tile, it has a little ship icon. That means that it is triggered. It is activated. When you have a ship on there as an activate action. This god over here, it has a little infinity symbol right there. That's to show you that it is a persistent ability that in this case happens during the winter solstice phase. All right. Then you have some tiles have a like the event, it has a exclamation point. That means that it is an immediate ability. It happens immediately when that tile is played. All right. So those are the trigger icons. Then you have the ability text for this. In this case, move one ship you control one step for each follower you have in the east. All right. So the ability is just what that tile does when it is triggered. Then below that you have the name of the tile, which in this case Volga Thrall Trade, and then you may have some flavor text below that. That is a tile. So I mentioned earlier the trade centers and powerful allies. They follow the same anatomy. So you have on the top, this is a trade center shown by the scales. The trigger icon shows that trade centers are persistent abilities and powerful allies are immediate abilities. It shows that you put, this type of follower on it. In this case, a Swedish follower. In this case, a Ruse follower. This is the ability, and it has a thing at the bottom here. That's how much money it costs to establish these particular posts, right? So venture posts are free, but trade centers and powerful allies cost this amount to establish. All right. So that is the tile anatomy. Next, I'm going to do the player board anatomy. So right here you have your player board. and your player board has four different types of followers. So you have your Jarldom followers, which are these. You have your Swedish followers, which are those. You have your Rus followers, and you have your Theocracy followers, right? You also have six different longships, and you have spaces for two advocates, one god, and then you have one special ability, which for some Jarls can have an extra tile on there. My ability doesn't do that, but Aud's ability does. So that is where you would put, like, advocates would go here, gods would go here, etc., etc. All right. So below that, you have your actions, your regular actions, and your influence actions, and then your sequence of play. So let's follow the sequence of play. The thing you're going to do on your turn is you're going to do the influence phase first, and that is take or return influence tokens for every follower you do or do not have the most of. So if you have the most Theocracy followers out at the start of your turn, you're going to take the Theocracy influence token, and you're going to put, these are your four action tokens right here, and you're going to put one of your action tokens there just to signify that you took that, right? If you do not have, if you have an influence token and you no longer have the most Theocracy, then you're going to put that back and take your action back. And that is the influence phase. Then you're going to do the action phase, which is use any actions that you have and any influence tokens that you have. In this case, I only have my four regular actions. So I'm going to do one of these five actions. These special actions over here can only be done if you have that influence token. So if I had that, then I could do the Theocracy action. But right now we're just going to concentrate on the regular actions. So let's look at them. The first one is invest. So invest, you're going to draw and refresh or buy from the Saga track. Now, everything that is capitalized is defined in the Rosetta Stone right here. So if you ever see anything that's capitalized and you want to know what it is, just look at the Rosetta Stone. It will answer every question that you have, hopefully. If it doesn't, I did not do my job right. So in this case, draw and refresh or buy from the Saga track. So what's draw? If you look at the Rosetta Stone, draw is draw a tile from the top of the Saga pile. What's the Saga pile? Well, Saga pile is the stack of unrevealed tiles on the zero cost space. So right here, that is the Saga pile. So I can draw off the top, right? Or I can, let me put these back. So I can draw off the top. And if I do, I refresh. Right, so refresh, we look at the Rosetta Stone, is refill empty track spots. If you just use the invest action to draw, first remove the one cost tile from the Saga track. That means that if I draw off the top, we're going to remove the one cost tile, and then these all go down, right? And that is actually done by this handy little script here. So you just press this orange button, it removes that, and then everything goes down, all right? So that is if you draw off the top. Otherwise, you can buy from the Saga track. So buy, this is the Saga track right here, is just paying the listed cost. So if I wanted to buy this tile, I would pay one silver. So we're using these counters here. So I just pay one silver and I take this into my hand. So we're going to be playing with open hands in this game. And that would be my invest action, is buying from here. You do not refresh after you buy, only if you draw off the top, all right? You will refresh at the end of your turn. So that is the invest action, all right? Next is the journey action. So the journey action allows you to move your ship up to three steps, and you may trade with co-located rivals during any step. So we'll do the first bit first. So the move ship up to three steps. What is a step? If you look at the Rosetta Stone, a step is one movement across a white border into or out of a region or into and out of a post, right? So you start from your home location Edla. You look at your home location. So my nameplate is green. That means that I know I'm in the green in the east wind. And I look for my emblem, which is this right here. My emblem is there. Right? So that means that I start here. Now, my home marker is listed in the Rosetta Stone. Home, each player starting location, not considered a part of any region. So this is not considered a part of a region. So I'm going to start here, and then I'm going to move 3 steps. So I can move 1 into the Caspian Sea or 1 into Cumania, right? And then I can move across white borders. So I can't move into Abbasid there because that's a black border. I can't move into Khazar because that's a black border. But I can move into Burtas, right? So I can move into there. And then I can move into this post here. Now, I can't move directly into this circle. I have to first go to Burtas and then go into the circle, which is the empty post. However, these harbor symbols right here, you can move directly into a post that has a harbor symbol. That means that if I'm in the Caspian Sea, I can move into this post or into this one or into this one. So I can move into Persia, India, or this empty post, but I cannot move into this one because it doesn't have a harbor symbol on that post, right?
Sure.
So I can move 1, 2 to go into India, or I can move 1, 2 to go into here, or 1, 2, 3 to go into Burtas. Okay? So that is journey. Now, you can trade as part of any journey action. So what's a trade? Well, if you look at the Rosetta Stone, a trade is exchange components and or non-binding promises with a co-located rival. What does co-located mean? Co-located is longships that are in the same region. A post is always in a region. That means that if I had a ship here and white had a ship here, we are co-located because we are both in the Abbasid region. So I could trade as part of my journey action. Let's say that I moved 1, 2, 3, and at any point during my journey action, so as part of my journey action, I can trade with white. Now, what might I want to trade with white? Well, if white has tiles that I may want, I may say, hey, white, I'll buy this tile off you for 2 silver. I can do that. You can trade any component. So I can say, hey, white, I will sell you this ship for 2 silver. So, you know, the ship goes back here and that goes there. And white gives me 2 silver, and you know that can be a trade. Maybe I'm bringing both of my ships in here, right? And it looks like I'm about to attack, and I can say, hey, white, I'm gonna take over India, but I'll give you 2 silver just to leave peacefully, just to leave your ship. And that'll save me an action. You get some money. And we don't have to come to blows. And white can say, yeah, sure, let's do that. So you take that, I give you 2 money, and easy, right? No bloodshed. So you can extort people. Any kind of trade, you can trade future non-binding promises if you want to. Any trade of components is allowed.
Sure.
All right, so that
I'm assuming if I'm doing a trade immediately, it is binding, but if it takes a turn, it's non-binding. Is that right?
Yes.
Like if I say I will give you some resources when I get them so you don't attack me, that's a non-binding agreement.
Correct.
Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes. Any deal that you're doing at the moment has to be completed. Yes. You can't just say I'll give you 2 to do this and then not do the thing because then that deal doesn't go through. But yes, sure, that is correct. Okay, so that is journey. Next is play. So play is if the requirement is met, resolve event or place or replace and establish. A lot to unpack there. So what is if requirement is met? What is the requirement? So if we go back to the Rosetta Stone, the requirement is have only your longship in a post in the area indicated at the top of the tile. So let's say that I want to play this event, right? So the area indicated at the top of the tau is Vinland. So for the requirement to be met, I have to have a longship, only my longship, in a post in the area indicated at the top of the tau. That means that I have to have a longship in Vinland, which is here, and I have to be the only one that has a longship in Vinland, and only then can I play this event. All right? So let's say that I've met that condition. This is here. I now play this event. So what's the next step? Resolve event. So what does resolve mean? We go back to Rosetta Stone, follow the instructions on the event tile, and I've actually rewritten this. It's now you must follow the instructions on the event tile, then remove it from the game, then check to see if anyone has met a victory condition. So for events, we do this. We resolve the event. So in this case, it's an all thing event, which is a special kind of event that means that we have to vote on it. So in all, what's an all thing? It's listed here in the Rosetta Stone. An all thing is if 50% or more of the players agree, perform the ability. That means that this ability will only happen if 50% of us agree that it should happen. So let's say I play this event, I resolve it, and resolving it means doing an all thing. All thing was the first parliament in Europe that the Vikings created. So so now I would have to go around the table and ask everyone if they agree that this event should happen. And if I get at least 50% of the players, so in this case, if I get at least three players, including myself, agree to it, then in turn order, all players are going to gain one tile from any rival's hand. Right? So if not enough players agree, then the event doesn't happen. The event doesn't trigger. So after the event triggers, we check victory condition. And the victory condition is just these right here. So we'll be playing with the standard conditions. And if anyone has met any of these victory conditions, the game is over. If multiple people have met the victory conditions, then it goes to tiebreaker, and the person with the most followers breaks that tie. But that is resolving an event. So the next step is resolve event or place or replace and establish a tile. Let's say that we have another type of tile, in this case, a venture tile, right? So I need to meet the requirement. So I need to have a longship in Volga. I have a longship in Volga, right? Now I've met that requirement, so I can play this. So it's place or replace and establish. So I'm going to place it here. If there was already a tile there and I have met all the conditions, I could replace a tile there. So I'm going to place it, and then I'm going to establish it. What does establish mean? Back to the Rosetta Stone. Place or replace a follower on the indicated follower icon and pay the listed cost if necessary. So there is no listed cost here. There are only listed costs on these, the powerful allies and trade centers. But I will place a follower. So this is a Rus follower that I have to place on there. So I'm going to take one of my Rus followers, and I'm going to establish it. And I have now established that tile, right? So that is now a tile that I have established. So that is the play action. Lot in there. If a requirement is met, resolve the event or place or replace and establish a tile. If it was an advocate, then it would go to, so if it was this right here, I would need to have again a ship in Vinland, and then I can play this here. I put it here, and then I put a theocracy follower on it, and I have established that advocate. If it is a god, it works the same way. All right? So that is playing. All right. Okay, so next is activate. So I have already played this event, I've already played this venture. How do I activate that ability that is on there? Well, using the activate action. And that's what this trigger symbol means here. So at the activate action is if you have a longship and a follower on a venture, perform its ability and exhaust a longship. So do I have a longship and a follower? Yes, I do. I have a longship here and I have a follower there. All right. So next, perform the ability. So in this case, I'm going to perform this ability, which is move one ship you control one step for each follower you have in the east. I have one follower in the east. That means that I can move one longship I control one step. So I perform that ability and then I exhaust a longship. So in this case, I exhaust this longship. I usually just flip it over like that to show that it's exhausted. And now that longship can no longer be used. So what does exhaust mean? It's in the Rosetta Stone as well. So it is mark or unmark that a component has been used. Longships, so that rule has been rewritten. It is now, you can't use any ship that has been exhausted. All right. So that is activating. You can only activate something as many times as you have longships. So if I have two longships there, I could activate that tile twice. If I only have one longship on there, I can only activate it once. All right. The last action is parlay. So parlay is if alone, establish. Otherwise, challenge, then if alone, establish. So let's say that I am here in Bilka, right? And I want to establish this post. To do that, I would do the parlay action. So if alone, establish. What does alone mean? Alone is have only your longships in a post. I have only my longships on this post, so I am alone. If alone, establish. So in that case, I establish. So I'm going to put my follower there, and establish as listed in Rosetta Stone is place or replace a follower on the indicated follower icon, and then pay the listed cost if necessary. There is a listed cost here of 7 silver, so I have to pay 7 silver in order to establish this. If I do not have 7 silver, I cannot establish this post. All right, and that is a parlay action. Now, what if I'm not alone? Otherwise, challenge. So let's say that I have this here, and there are two longships that have just come in to join me, right? So what does challenge mean? Back to the Rosetta Stone. Challenge is choose a rival in the same post who has fewer longships, then return rival's first longship and move every other rival longship to the nearest region. So I choose a rival in the same post who has the f fewer longships. So white can challenge me. I cannot challenge white. So white chooses to challenge me because they have more longships than I do. And then they're going to return my longship. And return, as listed in the stone, is return the component to its starting position. So its starting position is there. And now that was a successful challenge. So challenge, then if alone, establish. Am I now alone? Yes, I am the only one with ships there, or white is the only one with ships there. White is now alone, so they can establish. So they put a follower on there. I take my follower back, and that is a successful parlay. All right. If there were more, let's say there are two ships here, and I came back with three, because I really want it back, right? I would do a challenge. I have more ships, so I can do a challenge. The first ship is returned. The second ship is moved to the nearest region, in this case, Gonvik. And then I am now alone. I take this over, and that is a parlay. All right. That is all of your regular actions. There are influence actions, which are these four over here that you can only do if you have an influence marker. All right. And I'll go over them really quick. The ruse action allows you to target a rival's advocate if you are in their post. So, for example, if I had this right here, or sorry, that goes there. If I had this and white was in Vinland, they could use, and they had the ruse action, they could use the ruse action. So they just use the ruse action to target this advocate and steal it. And that now goes in their, that is now their advocate. All right, so
But
that
they
is.
do, sorry, question. They do
Yes.
still need to satisfy the cost for that, correct? So like the Vinland location.
Yes. I
Crap.
mean, they
Got it.
have to be in Vinland in order to steal it at all.
Right.
Right, so that is...
Oh, I see.
But, yeah, they don't have to establish it. They just have to be there. It's co-located.
Oh, no, it's in the target advocate's location. I see. Got it.
So that is the Rus action, the Sweden action. You draw from the saga pile. So you just draw randomly from the saga pile. If you turn up a venture, this is not a venture. So that didn't work. But if you had turned up a venture, you can immediately establish it. So you draw from the saga pile, venture, place a longship on the post, and play the venture. So let's say that I got this one as part of my Sweden action. So I can immediately put a longship here and then play it. And I have met my requirement because I have my lone longship there. And I can put that there like so. And I can establish it. So I can put this here like that. And that is now a successful Sweden action. All right. Next is the Jarldom action. So the Jarldom action, you can move one step into a post, then return one rival ship. Then if you are alone, you establish. So let's say that I had this here, and white was right there. All right. And white had the Jarldom action. So white could move one step from the Black Sea to this Byzantine post, then remove or return one ship. So they return this one ship. Are they now alone? Yes, they are. So they can establish it. All right. If I had two ships on there, they could go in there, remove one of my ships, but they are not alone, so they can't establish it. But sure. Generally, if you only have one ship protecting it, you can use a Jarldom action to take over that post. So that is the Jarldom action. Last is the Theocracy action. So the art, it hasn't been updated on this, but it has been updated in the rules. The Theocracy action is establish a Theocracy follower on any Theocracy venture or powerful ally. So essentially, if... you have the Theocracy action, you could put a Theocracy follower on an empty Theocracy post. So like this one right here, this powerful ally, you still have to pay the cost. You're still establishing it as normal, so you don't have to pay the $7. Or you can replace a Theocracy venture somewhere. Let's say that this was a Theocracy. It isn't, but let's say this was a Theocracy venture and white had the Theocracy action. They could just replace it, and they have now converted this follower to their own religion, right? So you can place it on powerful allies or ventures. You cannot place it in trade centers, so you can't use it to change Damascus over here. So those are the influence actions. You can only do those once on your turn, and only if you have the influence marker. You can do every other action as many times as you have action markers for, right? And so after the action phase, we go to Winter Solstice. During Winter Solstice, the first thing is that we gain silver equal to the unique followers that we have. So in this case, I have two unique followers out, so I get 2 silver. If I had this many followers out, I would still only get 2 silver, right? Because it has to be unique followers. That means that you will never gain more than 4 silver during Winter Solstice for having followers out, because there's only 4 unique followers, right? After that, you're going to discard down to your hand limit. Your hand limit is usually 4. It may change with abilities, but you discard usually down to 4, and then you refresh. So refresh is unexhaust anything, any markers that you have exhausted, so unexhaust any ships that you've exhausted, and refresh the saga track. In this case, we do one of these, and that's your turn. All right. We continue until somebody has met a victory. Somebody plays an event and they've met a victory condition. Or if all of the tiles are gone, we check for victory condition. All right. We're going to be there are 4 different difficulty levels: novice, standard, advanced, and a Eklundian. We'll be playing with a standard condition. Novice is really pretty easy. That's It's good for your first game, but really good for, like, you know, families, children, non-gamers. But standard is, you know, the standard conditions. All right, so that's enough to get started. Do we have any questions?
When you take the... When you're doing influence, determining if you take one of the four special actions, do ties allow you to take it if you currently have it, or do you have to give it back?
You have the most.
Okay.
If you do not have the most, you have to return it.
Well, sorry, it's just the terminology of having the most. Like, if I have three...
You have to have more than anyone else. Three.
Okay, that's...
All right, I'm going to move these back. We're playing a six-player game, so there are no extra tiles that are on the board. Oh, so we... Do I need to reset this up? No, I think I set it for five. All right. So that should be good. That means that we do need to have one venture tile out, so we'll just put Volga over here. And this is mine.
Andy, I do have one note. I was looking at the Rosetta Stone, and I noticed that the terminology for steel is not over there, even though it's
steel.
Capitalized.
Yeah, steel is gone, but the art. So Madeline, the artist, is currently on vacation, so the art has not been updated. But essentially, steel is now instead of saying steel, we just say what it does. Like in this case, it might even be here. Yeah, no, actually, it's still listed there. But steel is just take a tile and establish it. All right, so that's that. If you want, since we have new players, I could go first.
And that sounds like a good idea.
We can just go around. So I will, let me see what's going on here. I need to take my ships back.
Yeah, I have a rogue theocracy follower. I don't know if you see it. I was just going to clone one because I don't see it on the board anymore.
Yeah, I don't know where it is. So, you can just do it. I'll clone it for you. There you go.
Thank you.
Okay, so I am going to look at the tiles that are around Normandy. Buy up to three. No. Return. So these are all events. Wow, we got three events up front.
Also, everybody, after Andy in turn order, you take one additional silver for every space away you are from
him?
Yes.
So blue is going to get four, and then any extra additional money that is given to you. So white actually is going to get four additional after the money that they already get. So it's three, four, five, green gets six. And then Gunhilda is going to get 7 plus 4. So they start with 11.
Well, is that just player special ability? Like, where's the plus 4 coming from?
It's in this player special ability. Start game with an additional 4.
Does he start with that as well?
All right.
That's
where the follower is. Yeah,
that's
okay.
The advocate, and there's the archer as well. Yeah. I was going to say, like, what the...
Okay, so I'm going to shuffle these first.
So white would only have 7, correct?
No, they start with 11. They start with 7 and an additional 4 from their special ability, which is listed right there.
Ah, okay. Thank you.
All right, so I'm going to grab off the top... and that's actually pretty good for me. Okay, so then I did that, and that goes there like so. I'm going to journey. So I'm going to journey 1, 2 into Cumania. I'm going to play this. Uh, And that'll put a Jarldom follower out. So that was a invest action, a journey action, and a play action.
And you invested from the top, yes?
I did. Which is why I pressed the orange button to move that down, yeah.
Oh, okay, I didn't see that. I'm sorry.
I'm going to activate this ability. So that means I draw four from the saga pile, I keep two, and I discard two. So I'm going to draw four. And I'm going to keep two of these. So I will keep this one. And I'll keep that one. And then these two get discarded. Okay, so that is that was an activate. That's my four actions. Now I do Winter Solstice, so I get one silver, because I have one unique follower out. I don't have to discard down. I refresh, so I'm going to unexhaust this ship. And that's my turn. So it's blue.
Do we want to put a turn marker up, or I guess we'll just keep track? All right. So I have nothing to upkeep at the moment, and I only have four actions available. When I journey, do I start with a longboat already?
You move a longboat to your starting location, to your home marker.
Gotcha. So I don't. I have to journey to put one on the board in the first place. Okay. Gotcha. Gotcha. Guess I'm confused on what the end game is here.
All right, so here are the victory conditions, which I didn't go over. So the four victory conditions are: all of one follower type and at least one of every other follower type are established. So you're trying to get all of one follower and at least one of every other type. Have six established posts with only your ships, only ships of your color and no rival ships. Have at least two duchies. And duchies is both listed here and in the Rosetta Stone. Duchies are two regions with two established ventures each. And have one established post in every region in one wind. So you're trying to meet one of these four victory conditions.
Very well. And the only way for income is to establish. All right.
Yep, so I recommend trying to establish.
Something tells me I'm in the wrong place to do so, since I can't build anything here, and all of these cost more than I have at the moment. Let's see.
You can easily move, like in two turns, you can move to the other side of the board. So you're not really tied down.
All right. I guess I will use one to journey. Moves up to three. All right. So it starts here. This in itself is quote unquote a space that I have to move out of.
Yes.
I move to the next C zone. So that's one movement.
Correct.
And I guess since I already start there, I can use two and three movement to go here. Is that right?
Yes, so it would be one, two, three.
technically can move again, is that right? Provided I spend another action on there.
So you actually exhausted this ship. So at the end of your journey action, and I did write that. Yeah, so you exhaust the ship at the end of a journey action.
Ship's exhausted. It stays put. I can use another journey action to get another ship on the board?
Correct.
Okay. Gotcha. That still starts in my home port.
Mm-hmm.
Can't build any of these cards. I could draw off the top, though.
That's what I did.
Interesting. Okay. So I think I will buy from the saga track and use, if I understand my ability right, I pay zero for
advocates.
Whatchamacallit, advocates.
Correct.
So I'm thinking, since it looks like I'm all the way up here in the corner, I'm going to need a lot of movement. I'm going to try and get this guy.
Also, it might be worth grabbing things just so that you can sell them, because you get them for free, and if it's an advocate that you think somebody else might really want, you can try to sell it to them for some amount of money. Like, they can't afford 10 silver, but you know, sell it to them for half that or a quarter of that. That's still a profit to you.
Watch out. I will grab this guy. May not be able to use him right away, but... So, and I just click this button over here?
No.
It's the wrong button.
No, you do not refresh
the track at the end of my turn. All right. Two actions down. I think I will move another longboat out. Where does it need to go is the question. Okay, so we can go around that way too. Sure, we'll do that. So I'll take another journey action. Pop this guy here, move one, move two, I can move three, is that right? And I'm now in this region?
Yes.
Okay.
So you went one, two, three, yes.
So I got one action left, that boat is exhausted.
And if anyone that has currently joined us on Voice would like to actually see the game, the server is Viking and the password is Ion.
Hey, Andy, I didn't want to interrupt. It just kind of fills my heart with joy to see, you know, to see you just setting up playtest games and all that. It's just so nice.
Well, thank you. Thank you for providing the platform.
It's all thanks to Successful Geek. So if he ever plays with you, you can say that to him.
Yeah, we have a lot of really exciting new tiles to try out.
I will use my ability again and snatch this other advocate. And that should end my turn.
Yeah, the changes that we spoke about sounded extremely exciting. Jesse and I are about to meet up so that we could record a new podcast for Plated Once. I think we might do like three or four in a row. So maybe afterwards we can check it out. We definitely have to set up a time.
Yeah, let me know anytime.
Yeah, you got it. Well, I will not interrupt you guys anymore. I hope you're enjoying the game. And Andy, I will talk to you later.
Sure. Thanks for stopping in.
Yeah, you Adios. Got it.
All right, I'm going to start off by investing. My special ability lets me buy gods for free, so I will take this god into my hand. And I believe I need to be in the green region in order to add this god to my card, correct?
You need to be in the place listed up top. So the requirement is a post in the east for that one.
What I thought. So for my second action, I will journey. Long boat, pop out. One, into the sea. Two, into Bjarmaland. And then one into Starskoye.
Yeah, one, two, three. Yes.
Oh, and exhausted. And for three, I'm going to play.
You cannot currently play that tile. You have to be in a post in the east. So the requirement is, as listed, have only your longships in a post in the area indicated at the top of the tile.
Huh.
And you are not currently in a post.
That is a damn shame. Alright. Well then I will invest again. And I will spend one silver to take the event in Sarskoye. Not that I can play it right now.
Nope.
And I will just preemptively journey, sending a long ship out of port over to sea and then over to the Atlantic Ocean, just so I have some presence over in this general area for maybe a future turn. No idea if I'll need that or not. Oh, and
All right, let's see what we got here. Area, Finland.
What is the current hand limit in the rules?
Four.
Four. All right.
Question I probably should have asked earlier. When you add advocates and gods and whatnot to your player board, are they permanent or can you swap them out later?
You can replace them.
Okay.
You can anything that you establish, you can place or replace. So you're establishing advocates and it follows the definition. So place or replace a follower on the indicated follower icon and pay the listed cost.
Okay, gotcha. That being said, the old one does get discarded, is that correct?
Yes.
All right.
All right, so first action, I'm going to journey starting from starting point right here into Bjarmaland, into Pechenegs, and into Bertas for the three. Then on the second, I will invest to draw one.
So pro tip, just click the number one while hovering over deck.
Yeah. It'll just
draw one for you.
Yeah, I was trying to remember what exactly the keybind for that was.
You want to flip that over so the rest of us can see it?
We can see it.
I'm just seeing a card back on my end.
Oh.
I'm here.
I can see it. It's Byzantine. It's in a Byzantine event. It's an all thing. So in turn order, all players may place two ships in the Caspian Black or Middle Sea.
For some reason, both its front and back are exactly the same right now.
Yeah, it shows fine for me, but that may be a mod bug.
I mean, I can try, like, if I flip it and flip it back, does it reset?
No.
No. Maybe? No? No joy? All right.
Probably just a problem on our end, apparently.
Yep. might be able to fix it by logging out and logging back in, but that's just a lot of work right now.
Yeah, I can. I mean, it is what I said it was. So
yes. No, I believe you. I'm not.
No, I'm just letting you know. Like, if you need to know what it is, let me know, and I'll tell you what it is.
Right.
Check. And because those are drawn,
that's the only one that's currently, I guess, glitching. Everything else I can see fine.
Okay.
It's okay. I was playing a game a few weeks ago, a different game, where someone had two of their cards merge.
Ugh.
Where if you looked at it one side, it was the one card, but if you wanted to flip it over for its activated ability, it became a completely different card. And all right,
so Waterbeards is that. Still taking their turn?
Correct. And because that was drawn off the top, I discarded one from the track and reset it, thanks to the handy macro. I will.
That actually happens at the end of your turn.
No.
Oh.
That doesn't happen at the end of the turn.
You drew off the top. Never mind. That's right.
Correct. Okay, good. I'm not crazy. I will.
Oh, so that impresses the entire thing then. Okay, so even if you bought cards before, you could still potentially. Okay,
yes.
Interesting.
So if you want this, but it's you don't have four money, but you do have two money, you could grab one off the top, move this down, and now this is cheaper, and you can buy it for two.
Okay.
I will journey again. Goes Gardvik. German Ocean, and up into the Norwegian Sea. And I'm actually going to invest again. So you said one while hovering over. Oh, yeah, there it is. Does that one show for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Wild. All right, and that resets that again. That's my four actions. I have no followers out, so no income. That is my turn, and Jarek, it is to you.
All right. You want to switch the turnover?
Oh.
Cool. Thank
now
you.
Now it's to you.
All right. So I'm going to invest for my first action.
Oh, one thing about Ingvar, that the art wasn't updated on Ingvar for some reason. Actually, it has been updated. Never mind. I see it on there. So Ingvar's fine.
Okay.
All right.
Assume a change to the Jarl ability.
Yeah.
I'll invest again. Game apparently wants me to go to the east.
That's historically what we're dealing with, the Vikings that went east.
Yeah. Okay.
Can't let those westward Vikings get all the fun.
Yeah, they got a TV show. They've had enough fun.
All right, well, if that's the case, I'll pick up some reinforcements before I go. So I will journey. Going German Ocean and then into Dublin. And now I will parlay.
Oh, he has allied with the Irish. So he has a lot of early ships at his disposal.
All right. So I do three ships now.
So may I ask if somebody takes that spot over, do the ships respawn over here or they are left wherever?
They stay where they are.
Gotcha.
Is that it for, okay, actually I don't have my GUI up. So, all right. Yep, so,
So it's your turn.
I will go journey. Journey and do 1, 2, 3 to go up here. I will parlay.
You can't go through that border, right?
You are correct. I cannot do that. 1. Well, that's unfortunate. I guess I'll just head over to Bolgar then. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. This is done. It's not bad. I would need 3 advocates, which I don't really intend to get. So I can get a. After you establish, gain 3. That's not bad. I'm already in the south. Immediately take. Gain 3. Oh, that's actually. Yeah, let's journey again. So 1, 2, 3. It's another journey. We'll grab this one for 3 with my ability. 1, 2, 3. That's an invest action. We will grab one off the top. Okay. That is that. So 2 invests and 2 journeys. I get 1 income for having 1 unique follower out. And refresh the saga track.
And wait, that's my don't you have to do the other refresh because you drew from the top?
You're right. You're absolutely correct. And that's that.
Well, there goes the card I wanted. Anything that came out?
You're welcome to sample any of my wares.
So here's a question.
I don't have enough to pay for any of that, or anything that you want me to pay for it, I should say.
Someone had a question?
Yeah, for the Miklagard event showing on the track right now, take a random tile from a rival's hand. How is that going to play with open hands?
So you grab your tiles, and then you just flip them face down, you shuffle, and then you grab one.
All right, that'll work. So we will actually still randomize it then?
Yeah.
Cool.
Want to do that. All right. I think first off, do is use my ability and take this guy for free. And I have to be in the south to activate him. And establishing... Oh, it is a follower also. Okay. I like that. All right. Next, I'm going to go ahead and journey. See if I did this right. I'm going to take this ship and move it 1, 2, 3 in this port here. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
That means I have access to this location?
Correct.
Or basically gets placed in this location immediately?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right. And let me make sure that was the correct spot to go to. It looks like it was. All right. So, since I am there, I'm going to go ahead and establish
this you're, guy. Yeah, you're going to play. Establish
play,
is in an
excuse
action,
me.
But no.
So I'm going to play this guy. He's going to go right there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, whoops. Order matters, excuse me. Since I am in the south, I'm going to play this one. There we go. And then I can use my second action to play again. I'm going to use this guy.
Yes. You only get this ability when you establish powerful allies.
Powerful allies. Okay.
Yes. So.
Gotcha.
The handshake
okay.
symbol.
Then
that's
I,
the powerful
I read
allies,
that so. Wrong. A-okay. That'll be A-okay. I got both of those down. That's all of my actions. I do get 2 coins if I'm looking at this correctly.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And that's going to end my turn.
All right, I am going to start things off with an invest. Taking this lovely god card for free. I'm going to journey. 1, 2. I'm going to play. To install the goddess Saga. And then I will play to establish this tile in Volga. My income is 2. Refresh the market. That is my turn.
All right. So my first action is going to be a journey. Oh, geez. Sorry. Taking this one into the Caspian and into India. And if I'm reading this right, that's exhausted after a journey, but that can still be used for non-activate actions. So I can establish in India, which for my Jarldom ability, it's the first time I'm doing that, so it costs 3 less. Oh, God.
Okay, put it down gently and... We'll lock it.
Yep, let's lock that. There we go. That's what I wanted to grab.
So you pay 9?
6, because it's the first time doing it.
Right.
That was a parley action. Next, we're going to invest again. And do one more journey into Bjarmaland, into Pechenegs, and then into a location on Pechenegs. End of my turn. I have one follower type out, so that's one money, and that is my turn.
All right. My first action. Move these off. First action, I'm going to invest. Man, there's a lot of green cards out here.
That's the interesting bit of playing a random selection of from 220 tiles.
Yep. All right, and so for my next three actions, I'm just going to journey three times. And let's go.
Ah, damn it. I totally forgot. My god allows me a special power during winter solstice.
One, two, three. One, two, three. And I'll bring another one out from here. Go one, two, three. And I needed to discard and refresh for my first action. Okay, and that's it for me. I get one income.
Okay. I will move one, two, three into Fatimid. That's a journey. I'm going to play this Fatimid venture right there. And that gets me that. So that is a play. I'm going to move one, two into Bolgar, three into there, and then I'm going to play this, which gets me another Ruse follower. And that is that was another journey and another play. So I have two unique followers, one, two money, and that is my turn.
All right then. Now for clarification, even though I'm in this region, I can't move from here to here. Is that right?
Yes, you cannot move a ship through the mountains, no.
Okay. So I literally have to take the long way around.
Yep.
Duly noted. Duly
noted.
So
you have to go into the Black Sea and then take this little river to the Caspian Sea, and then you can get into Persia. Mm-hmm.
Check, also, check.
Also, do note, you have the most Sweden.
Yes, so...
Hmm?
So you do your influence action first, and you check to see if you have the most followers of any given type, and you currently have the most Swedish followers, so you get the Swedish influence token.
Okay. I will take that. That one specifically, draw from the saga pile, if it's a village, place, and play. Okay. So I can either save. I'm assuming I can save these tokens correctly.
This is one of your action tokens, which can be used as
one.
Yeah, so you can be used as an action token or to take the Swedish influence action.
Okay, and I keep this so long as I have the most, or I keep it until I use it as.
You keep it as long as you have the most.
Okay. That is interesting. Place. I want to do that. You know what? I have currently nothing better to do, so yeah, I'll go ahead and use that action. So I just draw from the pile. Mm-hmm. And it is not a village, so I don't get to use the rest of that effect. Okay. Do I want to move that way? I think I'll go ahead and use a journey action. Get a ship out and move it one, two, three onto Greenland. That's one, two, and three. Now, is the dock in the sea, or I have to move onto the dock?
So you started here, right? So yes. It's one so to get one, into the Norwegian Sea, one to get into the Greenland two, Sea, and then one to get three. Into Greenland.
Okay. Gotcha. Those are immediate effects, though. Okay. So be it. So be it. It'll be fine. So that's two of my actions down. I'll go ahead. Let me take that back. I'm just going to move them here instead. Since I can go ahead and get the other thing immediately, I'll use the next journey to move this ship one, two into this Byzantine area. Mm-hmm. And I'll go ahead and play this card. That should give me one of these guys.
It will give you two of those. Your third advocate placed over here, and it's listed in your... You can have three play...
Play
your third
okay.
here and place an additional follower of the listed type.
Gotcha. Okay. That is interesting. All right. So, at the end of my turn, I get three coins now. Is that right?
You have three unique followers. So, yes.
One, two, three. I will take that, and I did not mess with this deck, so I'm done.
All right. First thing, I will journey this ship.
Now, all the cards in the deck are unique, is that correct? Mm-hmm. Or are they duplicates?
No, they're all unique abilities.
Gotcha.
220 unique abilities. We're playing with 12 times 5 of those.
Gotcha. Now, and I'm assuming the deck reshuffles if we ever run out?
If we run out, the game is over.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Never mind then.
I have to date not seen that happen. I haven't seen it happen since it was a lot harder to win the game.
Again. All right, winter solstice. I gain three, and I place a ship and move one step. Place a ship. There. Actually, just keep it at my home. move. I'll move this ship to the
okay, let's see, this guy, I'm gonna refresh. I should have the most of the Jarldom followers now, so I'll go ahead and grab that.
Watch out.
YOLO. Going to reading my board upside down. I'm gonna journey. One, two. Stop early. Then I'm actually going to use the Jarldom action to move one into a zone, remove a rival longship, and then establish.
That's not nice.
So
you sure you don't want to trade first?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Maybe I can offer you some, you know, some compensation.
Maybe. Well, that ship has sailed, as they say. Let's see what's next. What's next? Yeah, I will invest to grab one off the top. Let's actually go ahead and reveal that.
Oh, ooh, that's less useful than I thought.
It's a new one.
Bad.
And I will actually invest again. Take one more, which does mean I need to discard. End of my turn, I still only have one unique follower type, so I only take one.
And you drew from the top twice?
I did. I think I might need to refresh again, though.
Yeah, yes, you will.
I just couldn't remember if I had or not.
Alrighty. Well, I am going to journey here for one. Gonna journey again, one, two, and three.
Looks like someone's gonna get a duchy.
Four. Well, I'm gonna protect this over here because I don't wanna leave it wide open. And then, yeah, I will play. Let me see what everybody has. Okay. All right, yep, I'm going to play this guy. You know what, in that case, I'm actually going to end my move. Nope, I'm going to keep it there. Okay. So that was three journeys and a play, so that is done. Two silver.
Okay, I'm going to invest this Byzantine tile. So that is then I will journey. One, two, three into Bortas. And I'm going to play this Bortas tile. So So that is a journey and a play. And then I'm going to journey again. Actually, can I just place two of my things here? That's about the same. I guess it does save me some trouble, but not a huge amount. All right, fine. I will activate this ability to put two more ships on this post. So one, two. No, I'm not going to do that. I will move. I will journey one, two, three. Right, because otherwise one, two, yeah. So that's another journey action. And that's my turn. I have two unique followers, so I get two money. One, two. And I'm done.
All right.
Oh, so I think I had... No. Yes, I believe I have the Rus follower, actually. Or the Rus influence action.
So at the start of my turn, I need to check if I still have the Dutch. Is that correct? Nobody else has any Dutches out at the moment? Nope. So I no longer have the most.
Dutch?
Or is that, what is this one?
The Swedish.
Swedish, excuse me. So I no longer have the Swedish ability. However, does anyone have two Techeri? Yes. No. No.
Theocracy?
Theocracy. Excuse me. Nobody does, so I guess I'll be taking that one instead. So if... So steel is stealing an opponent. Let me see. Steel is... Oh, it's not in here, is it?
Essentially, it's taking it. Just taking it and establishing it.
Okay. To pay a cost. I still have to pay a cost if it has a cost associated with it, correct?
Yeah, but you, when you're stealing advocates, there's nothing. There's no cost. And that's the only time that steel is used currently.
So there advocate. Will be no okay, cost. That's what it is. Gotcha. Advocate. I think I'm the only one with advocates right now, so I guess it's a good thing I have this. So be it. All right. In that case, that will cost me.
Sure. So you have the Theocracy influence action, which allows you to place.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm looking at the wrong one. Excuse me. I am looking at the wrong one. Replace a follower.
Place or replace. So you can put a Theocracy follower there or there, or you can replace this one.
Okay. Which you can just get back. Although correct. I could use the ability here.
You can't use the ability until you have a longship on there.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. But I can have the marker there, I just can't use the ability.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. And placing a marker does not allow me to use the abilities anywhere else because I don't have ships there either.
Yeah, you can. So you only need a ship when you're activating an ability. You don't activate this ability. When you establish this, you immediately get it. And when you establish this, you immediately get it. The trigger symbol tells you when it happens. So the trigger symbol here is a ship, okay. So you need a ship.
Immediately. Okay, yeah. Gotcha. Okay. I see it now. Okay. Interesting. Do I want to use that? I'm going to hold off at the moment. I will go ahead and establish, which is this activate, correct?
So what are you trying to establish? Is not an action. What are you trying to do?
I want to gain the help of these mercenaries here.
All right, so you're going to do a parlay action.
Parlay. Oh, there it is, parlay. All right, I am alone, and I'm going to be spending 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And now I get to put a token there. Boom. So these ships are now under my control. It's a journey right now. Is there anything good in here? Probably not. I will go ahead. I'll go ahead and journey. Make a new ship. This one's going to go 1, 2, and 3 there. And I'll go ahead and use this theocracy ability. Place a father of, okay, so I can place on any territory or post. So I'll place this.
You have to pay the listed cost.
Oh, that's right. That's what I'm missing.
So you could take this one, and that's the only thing you can take right now.
Yeah, that's not really worth it. So I jumped the gun. I thought I could get these guys moving for free, but that's not the case.
You can still use that to do a regular action.
Firm. Two may move. Okay, that's interesting, but I'm nowhere near that location, am I? Kind of. I'll draw off the top. I'll go to invest, take the top card. Okay. And this will drop it down by one. Oh, excuse me. This ability did activate, correct? I did make friends with a powerful ally.
You did establish a powerful ally, so you do gain 3 silver.
1, 2, 3. I will take that. Do I want to? That seems a little bit useless. Ah, sure. You know what? Why not? I'll pay 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I will buy this god card, and I will not be able to play it immediately.
And because
that ends my turn.
Because that is a Yharnam Saga card, I gain 4 for that on account of Ilya.
Okay.
Sweet.
Did not realize you had that, so go ahead, take your spoils, and my turn ends.
Okay. Andy, I have a question about Dublin.
Mm-hmm.
To parlay, I have to be able to challenge. To challenge, I have to have more longships. He has one longship, and then there's one Dublin longship there. Does that mean I need 3?
Yes.
Or 2? All right.
3.
Okay. Taking 1, 2, 3 journey actions. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2. And then I'm going to parlay. And because I have the goddess Hell, after winning a challenge, I return 2 of your rivals instead of 1, except he doesn't really have two there. He only has one there.
Yes, it would mean that this one, if you were anywhere else, it would mean that this one would go to its starting location, which would be here. So if it was like all the way over there, it would go back here. But since the nearest zone is its starting location, it doesn't matter.
Sure. It'll just be in the sea near Dublin instead of actually in Dublin like all my ships are. And then your Jarl Rimfarler goes back to your board. I get to put one out. And I have to pay the... Do I have to pay the 9 silver for that?
You do.
Okay.
When you parlay...
I thought I did. I wanted
so, yeah. It's if alone establish, otherwise challenged, then if alone establish. And then establish is...
Right. I just wanted to double check.
Yeah, but following the flowchart is helpful to kind of cement it. And then establishes replace a follower on the indicated follower icon and pay the listed cost if necessary.
And I'm correct in assuming that does not count as a saga tile for purposes of India, right? Saga is just God's followers events and ventures.
So for India, any Jarldom tile that is purchased, you get the money for.
Well, this isn't purchased, that's a parlay, so still no then.
No.
Yeah, and it's actually not a tile, it's an existing...
Right, that was correct. That was the original question, is that doesn't count as a saga tile, as indicated by the face down icon.
Yes. It is not a tile at all.
Right. That's what I thought. Alright, so starting out, we're going to journey... Oh, sorry, I'm still peak Jarl, so I still have that tile.
And actually, this longship is here. Because you only had 4 moves. You moved 3 and then established, or challenged, parlayed. So yeah, that one's there.
Yes, and my end of game action allows me to move one of my ships, so I did.
Got it.
We're all good. We're good.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Yeah. Sorry. The first action was a journey onto the Throne of the Log there. And then I will play Uller as my god. Then I will journey one more into Gondvik, into Bjarmaland, and into Sarskoya. And then I will Jarldom action to move one more into this Sarskoya zone, return this Dublin longship, and we said that goes back to the starting zone in the ocean, correct?
Yes.
And establish that, if White doesn't mind me moving this.
Ingvar is keeping the Jarldom alive.
Yeah, it's good.
Some of us are trying to, you know, progress to the all thing and you know, a parliamentary system of working out our differences in a political fashion. But no, Ingvar's like, I'm just gonna Jarl my way to the top.
Sometimes the old ways are the best ways. I have 3 unique follower types, so that's 3 coin, and because of Uller, I gain 1 more for that. And that is my turn.
All right, well, since I'm back at square one, let's see what I want to do now.
Yeah, you've been wiped off the map there.
I have 1 ship on the map still. Not that, you know, that's, okay, well, I'm going to, I'll do invest.
Okay. I will invent right first. Out.
I've rewritten all of these since. So we actually were. We got the mod updated because I wanted to start playtesting the tiles before I actually rewrote them for clarity, which I did last night. So these are not super clear, but still pretty clear. And they've been already rewritten and updated, so that'll go into the mod probably tomorrow.
Yeah. These would be great if I had something in the south. Okay, well, I guess I'll... I'll invest off the top again.
Hand limit comes into play immediately or at the end of turn?
Winter solstice, you discard down to your hand limit.
Gotcha.
You did draw off the top, correct?
I did. So I'm just deciding if I want to do it a fourth time.
Turn four.
Kazar, I like it.
I'm just trying to see what's coming out in this pile since it's ever shifting.
Yep.
Is that it for you, Bryn?
No, I've still got one more. I'm just deciding because I can't get any cards that I can actually play here. So Let's invest again. Now, of course.
I mean, I like those tiles. Maybe I'll buy them off you.
Well, I didn't.
We aren't co-located, so but. Might not be worth it.
Yeah, I didn't journey. Are we co-located?
We are not co-located. You are only here.
Right.
So I would have to go all the way over there, and that is quite the trip for me. I mean, I could get there, but I'm not gonna.
Right. All right. Well, I'm gonna ditch this Sarskoye since I was kicked out of there nicely, and then let's. And get rid of Bulgarls. So
okay,
and I get no income. Awesome.
So I'm going to journey 1-2 into Byzantine. I'm going to use. Do I have any? I still have the Rus. I'm still the leader of the Rus. All right. So I'm going to use my Rus action to take this this guy right here and place him right there. You can have your theocracy back. So that is that. I shall. Czar right there. I'm going to grab this Czar for 3. 1, 2, 3. And then I will, I'm going to play this guy. All right, so I have 3 unique followers. 1, 2, 3. And that's that. So we refresh and we're good.
Okay. Let me see. I'm no longer... I no longer have access to this, so I just get a normal action token back. I get everything else back. I am down a follower to boot. Not particularly happy about that. That would stop that. Would indeed. I guess I will first off, I'll go ahead and, I'll draw the top card off the deck. And that scoots everything down. We have here, okay, not exactly what I was looking for, but I did invest. I'm going to go ahead and journey. That will move 1, 2 into here. And can't do all three, can I? No. All right. Can only buy one. Ah, drat. That's unfortunate. Do I really want to move? Is the question then? All right, so I'm going to take that back, that journey. He's going to stay put for now. I need that action for something else. I'll go ahead and buy a card from the shop or invest. I will pay 4 for this event. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I will play this event. So since I am in the Byzantine area, I can, if this location is unoccupied, I can immediately establish it without paying anything.
There you go.
Do I read that right?
Yep, nicely done. You now control Miklagard. It's neither Istanbul nor Constantinople. It's Miklagard.
This goes immediately in the discard.
It immediately goes out of the game, actually.
Out of the game, okay. All right, that was a play. The next play...
Technically, we check for victory, but no one has met the victory condition, as far as I can tell.
Okay. One more action to do. And I'll go ahead and play another card. It'll be this god card, so I can get it up and running. At least... And
if we were playing the advanced victory conditions, you would have met one of the victory conditions.
And what victory condition would that have been?
It would have been 2 advocates, 1 god, two powerful allies, and the key trade centers count as a wild. So you do have a powerful ally, and then you have Miklagard as your wild.
Okay. Well, unfortunately, we're not playing that version, so I get no points towards victory at the moment.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I think we played with that one last time.
I do have 3 unique tribes, so 1, 2, 3 for my income, and this allows me to take the top card of the deck as well. Top card of the discard pile, excuse me, not the deck.
Actually, you also need 2 ventures, which you didn't have. But
I'm sorry?
You also needed 2 ventures. That's part of the Jack of All Trades, so it's not quite... You weren't quite there. But you do have 2 ventures available, so you could play them.
10-4. Well, that is going to end my turn. I don't think I've triggered any other of my abilities at the moment, so... Next. And I did not negate that either. That's a problem. Whoops. Oh, well. Oh, sorry, I did forget to push the button.
It's all right. I pushed it for you. Wow. All right. Okay. Two journeys. One, two, three. Parlay. So goodbye, green. I guess so. We'll just take a journey. Move one of these government ships. One, two, three. And I have three unique.
Andy, quick question. So this Pechenegs event here, oh geez, I'm frozen. There we go.
Gain five silver, this one. Pay one silver to a co-located rival.
That requires the existence of a co-located rival, yes?
It does not require the existence of a co-located rival. If there is no co-located rival there, you just gain the five.
Oh, okay,
I mean,
cool.
I can write, if possible, pay one to a co-located rival, but I should probably do that.
So, yeah, well, I'm going to go ahead and do that. So that is a play to play this Pechenegs action and discarded or removed from the game.
Events are removed from the game.
Gone. That gives me 5+1 for my Uller, so I'm at 16. Let's journey a long ship to Gondvik, German Ocean, Norwegian Sea. Then let's Jarldom action onto Pharaoh, which removes one blue longship.
Does it not?
Does indeed. And I can afford to establish there, so I will indeed.
Take that back too. All right, well, there goes my plans next turn.
4, 5, 7. And I now have control of the Faroese longships. To which end? Actually, for this last one, I'm just going to activate my Kimania one. Gain 4 tiles, which one is now weirdly hidden. I might have hit the wrong button because it only gave me 3. Wait, is the sock pile empty?
It isn't empty. Somebody grabbed the entire stack. So we need to find that
person. It was not me.
Where have they gone?
I have nothing in my hand other than whatever's in front of me right now.
Yeah, I've just got these 4. Oh no.
You want to try to push the undo button or...
No, I think it's right. I think we have gone through that many because I've been watching the stack.
Well, there's 21 over here.
Yeah, we've been burning through it pretty hard.
Actually, okay, so that triggers a victory check?
No, all the tiles have to be gone.
Got it. See, that was my last action anyway. Activate. I have 2+1 types out. And that is my turn.
We have discarded 21 tiles.
We did
high, but
we drew a lot off of the top.
That's cheaper to just draw off the top, so that's what we've been doing.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, and like last time, I didn't have any cards that I wanted to buy. They were down there, so I drew 4 off the top.
No, that's fine. Mm. That works.
Which, yeah.
Taking that messed up my entire plan. I hope you know that.
You did want an interactive game.
I did. I was expecting to at least hold. I was assuming you were coming for it. I wasn't expecting you to do it this turn. Should have, but I wasn't expecting it. Oh, well, back to the drawing board.
No one expects Vikings.
Gird of God, baby.
No one expects the Swedish Inquisition.
So I'm going to journey 1, 2, 3. I am going to...
Work that way. Okay, 5, fine.
I'm going to journey 1, 2, 3. I am going to play this guy. And then I'm going to buy this one for 1.
Card did you just buy?
This Svea.
Sure. 10-4. I gain coins if you're buying a certain type, and that's not the type I'm looking for.
Gotcha.
Not that it matters much, but Kronos Phantom, you'll get the Sweden tile, and you'll get to draw from the saga file if you want.
Yes, kind of empty though, so I think that's moot.
Yeah.
Oh well, I get bragging rights, right?
Get to be maximum Swede.
This are useful to me. That might be useful.
All right, I'm going to, do I still have the ruse? believes. No, I do not.
No, you died. I've tied with me.
Well, that's not. It's not nice. Ingvar. It's just not a very nice man.
I mean, look at him. He's obviously very grumpy, and he's got a floppy hat. So.
I was gonna steal this advocate. Okay. One more round to do things.
Probably not intended, but may I ask if these master trade areas, like this gains all for Swedish buys, if I buy a Swedish card, does that trigger
yes.
for me as well?
Yes, it does.
So I get Swedish cards for free, provided I can pay for them.
Correct.
Okay. Interesting.
So I'm going to grab that for three.
That money comes to me then.
Yes. So you get three.
Thank you. I knew how that's how that worked. I would have been going after those earlier. Huh. Well,
it's
live
hard
and learn.
To go after them early because they cost so much.
Affirmative. No, I mean, I would have been aiming, gunning for them earlier on, if that makes sense. Plan for it. There we go.
Just curious, which branch of the military were you in?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm actually not a part of the military. I am a military brat, which means I was born in the military, but I myself have not joined.
Gotcha.
To answer your question, my father was part of the Air Force.
It has been far too long since I've heard the terms you're using during online voice communication. Not since I've played EVE Online. So.
Understood then. I've also worked with, I guess, walkie-talkies or radio. So many, like 10-4 and whatnot, is usually for people who want or use that type of communication on a regular basis as well. So it's not 100% military, but yes.
I know my affirmatives
and whatnot are more or less military-based.
Also, I believe you said a few times, you said check.
Yes, that is correct as well.
That was also a trigger for me. I'm like, all right.
I'm going to activate this ability and move two longships there. And I'm going to journey 1, 2, 3 into the Black Sea.
Okay. Try.
No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that first bit. So I'm not going to I'm not going to activate that. I have currently invested, and that is it. going to go 1, 2, 3 into Abbasid. And I'm going to play. So that is a journey and a play. And I'll journey again to go into there. And that's my turn. I have three unique, so 1, 2, 3. And I'm done.
All right, then. I believe I'm going to... I guess I first of all exchange one of my action tiles for the Swedish one. Not that that matters. I will go ahead and I'm going to first off take a journey 1 and 2. He does flip over. All right. I would like to establish a lone stat. There we go. So parlay. I'm going to try to establish this here. Yep. Now, if I understand correctly, since my ship is exhausted, I cannot use the ability. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. So that is that. Let me see. Is there any easy way of doing that? No. One short. Okay. In that case, I will go ahead and use 1 to invest, and I'll grab this for free. And I'll use my last one to play it, since I'm already in that location. And my turn is now done.
All right. I'm just going to journey, 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 and parlay.
You get two coins.
Two.
I get the top card of the discard pile as well. Sorry. Now I'm done. Not that this card's going to help me. Nope.
This one's going to move 1, 2, 3.
That's not very nice.
1, 2, 3. And I'm going to parlay. And because I have the goddess Hell, both of your longboats go home.
That's not very nice at all.
Try grabbing the longboat.
Well, yeah, well, maybe don't put it right on top of my longboat, and I can do it.
Your longboats are being extra finicky tonight. I'm not sure why. And I can put...
So I put an extra longship on there, and you still had to go for it, huh?
Oh, yeah. All right. That's my four actions. I have four uniques. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 coins. And my turn.
All right. I am still peak Jarl. Oh, wow. Blue's got all of their Swede followers out. I did not notice that.
Oh, a lot of good it does me.
Well, that's one of the victory conditions.
1, 2. Yeah, it does. 1, 2.
No, it's not. The other part of that is to have the rest. And I presently am lacking in two categories, so, and I'm trying to figure out if I can actually get any more to fit in a quick time span. It doesn't look like I can, so.
Right. Well,
and that checks at the end of the round or the end of my turn?
What checks?
These victory conditions.
The victory condition happens when you play an event.
An event, okay. So they check.
Or,
okay,
or
so
if
I,
these four tiles get purchased.
Gotcha. Duly noted. Duly noted.
Alright, well, my first action was to go ahead and play Tori the Torkoal's Daughter. When I end a journey on a west post, I gain 2 coin. Second, I'm going to journey into Gardvik, into German Ocean, and onto Normandy, which end on a west post, so I gain 2+1 for my god. 2, 3. I'm going to parlay to establish on Normandy, and I may exchange a Jarldom follower on another tile with one of my own. So I'm going to snag this Sopme post here. White, if you want to grab your Jarldom follower there. Thank you. And then lastly, I will journey one more into Gardvik, into Sopme, and onto the onto the post. It made it so much worse. That is my 4 actions. I have 2 follower types, so I gain 2+1 coin, and that is my turn.
All right. So what's the second tiebreaker, Andy, if followers are tied?
Money.
Wow.
You know what? I'm just gonna invest 4 times.
Okay.
That is. Do you have the money for that?
No. Invest is in draw.
No. You can't do that. There is no more top.
So you can't just cycle a deck.
No. You have to buy off, and you could do that. You could, I mean, if you had the money, you could buy off 4 of them. But yeah, you can't. You can no longer draw off the top because there's nothing to draw. Once they are in here, you must pay money for them.
Okay. All right. Well, I mean, I wasn't even taking them. I was just doing it to.
Sure, but to like, once a tile is in a listed cost, you have to pay the listed cost for it.
Well, I mean, like I said, I wasn't taking them.
He was doing the action to discard the cards.
Sure. Yes, but I'll have to.
But you have to do the entire action, and it's yes. You have to do the.
I will. It's something to note. I have to note that you can only do that. You can only draw when there's something to draw.
All right. So.
It rarely gets to this point, so actually it hasn't been an issue before now.
I'm going to play. Play that there. I'm going to journey. One, two. I can't get there. Oh, wait, yeah, I can. Okay. Hold that thought. So for my second action, I'm going to journey 1, 2, 3. Over there. Then I'm going to journey 1, 2, 3. And then I'm going to parlay and kick him off.
Oh, I never clicked my end turn, but I guess it'll come back to me.
Oh, I just sent it to you.
Oh, okay. So it's my turn?
Yep.
All right, then. So I shall journey and move this guy 1, 2 into Kashar. I'm going to play... to play this right here, like so. I'm going to journey again to move, let's just move one of these. So one into Cumania, one into Portas, and then one into that post. And then I'm going
Andy
to
wins.
Play this event in the east. And this
Andy
event, gain one advocate from the saga track and establish it. So I'll gain this advocate from the saga track and I'll establish it. You must resolve the event. So actually, if the event causes you not to win, that is a situation. But that didn't happen in this case. So yes, this was played. Check for victory. I have met my victory condition. I have one post in every region in the south. And that's that.
Well done.